Carl and Lou here from Games, Brains and the Headbanging Life, GBHBL.com for short, and it's track by track time. We're doing something a bit industrial, a bit, well, I would say different, because, you know, we've done Nine Inch Nails before, have we?
Oh, I think we have.
What album? The debut, wasn't it? Yeah, I think we've done the debut album.
Yeah,
I can't quite remember, but this is With Teeth. We're doing With Teeth, which is far from my favourite.
Really?
In fact, there was a few problems with this one.
Like
I think we'll get into it. Don't say that when I say like it's far from my favourite. They've got a lot of fucking albums.
Yeah.
So like, to be fair, that there's a wide array of choices you can have there. But it is With Teeth, the fourth studio album by the industrial rock band Nine Inch Nails, released by Nothing Records and Interscope on May 3rd, 2005. The album became the band's second to reach number one in the US and was certified gold by the RIAA. We got a long one here. So we're going to dive straight in with all the love in the world. A mix of sexiness and subtlety in that beat works for me. I like how the vocals get more and more powerful and the electronica rhythm seems to grow. It really is a strong opener, highlighted by how it develops bit by bit as it goes on. A slight tone shift makes it seem darker as more cinematic touches come in and the piano is top notch. It's a grower of a track.
Yeah.
It's one you stick with.
I find, like the nice and slow, subtle effects laying in the beginning. There's unedited quality to Trent's vocals that I like.
Okay.
It felt quite raw. When he kind of gets more like
into
why did you get all love in the world? I really do like that. I really like the ending and the drum effect. I really like that. And it's got like a melancholy feel that I really appreciate. It's a real strong opener.
It's a good opening, yeah. Mm. It is. Yeah. You know what you are. I love that we get a wider injection of industrial heaviness here. Mm. Talk about smart positioning, as after the opener, this track sounds so much more energised. Mm. It is a bit of a retread of older Nine Inch Nails stuff, but the ferocity works for me. I really enjoyed this one.
Mm. Nice mini drums on this one. Picks up the pace. I really like the depth when it kicks in. Don't you know what you fucking are? When it sings, there's like a drop in like the bass of it when it actually kicks in.
I know, I heard it.
Yeah, I know. Feels punky and aggressive, which is nice against the slower tracks.
Do you agree what I said?
That's
a bit of a re-thread. Keep saying thread, tread.
Yeah, but I do like that.
Okay. The Collector. The beat gets my feet moving and the passion of the vocals bleeds through. I think this is a good example of both the old and new sounds of Nine Inch Nails, but it's not one to thrill me.
Yeah, same. Enjoyable track, but not my favourite.
Mm.
It doesn't do enough to me compared to the other more layered tracks,
okay.
But it's short enough. So it just
comes and goes.
Yeah. Yep.
The Hand Up Feeds. The EDM industrial groove of this one is Club 4 filler stuff.
Yep.
A special kind of club, though, as it's still Nine Inch Nails.
Yep.
It's not your average club. Catchy and accessible. This is some good danceability to it. And I'd be lying if I said I didn't find myself moving a little bit to it.
Man. Still absolutely love this track.
Love it.
Right. The groove and bite of it is great. It ramps up vocally too.
Okay.
And obviously that's what makes it Nine Inch Nails, when he actually screams the lyrics at the end. It's not just like all the same. It's like, I'm actually going to put some oomph into it. It's just a great song that feels very nice. It is Nine Inch Nails.
Yeah. I'll go with that. Yeah. Love Is Not Enough. The tempo is taken down for a methodical pace that features some dirty sound and percussion at the start. Mm. With some unusual noises, it gets rawer and darker, leading to a shift that makes it a more intense listen. Enjoyably strange, but still with Nine Inch Nails' discernible rhythm.
I really like the opening effect. Mm-hmm. It's so dark. I really like the layering of the sound and vocals. I like the songs that I can get lost in.
Okay.
Found it with this one that I really got lost in it.
All right.
It's just my personal thing.
Every Day is exactly the same. The early sexiness is back with this moody fat foot tapper and body shaker. An accessible groover with some dark and shadowy touches layered throughout. The chorus is very catchy too.
I do like on this album that the songs like this are thought out. So even the piano intro has a subtle effect.
Mm-hmm.
I really like the lyrical content of Every Day is Exactly the Same. Just the idea of like...
Oh,
just,
right, yeah, okay.
You're there, but nothing's really kind of offending you or making you feel upset. It's just you're just here.
Mm.
And I really like that.
Okay.
I really like the bridge and the feeling I get from it. And when I read about this album, it was kind of done during like time where Trent was going to rehab and stuff. Okay. So it's kind of quite introspective where he's kind of reevaluating stuff.
Okay.
That kind of comes across. Yeah.
I don't necessarily agree with that. Not knowing that detail, it's not something that then jumped out at me.
Yeah.
I think if you know it, it comes across. But if you don't know it, you're not like, oh, okay, this sort of has a resonates with me in that fashion. Yeah. The title track, With Teeth. The buzz of the industrial is uncomfortably strong here, and this is one of the more unbalanced tracks on the album. Strange and hard to predict. It's enjoyable for that, but I can't say I find myself that into it. I think it overstays its welcome at over 5.5 minutes long, and just never really goes anywhere that interesting. The point where it seems to end, around a halfway mark, is pointlessly drawn out.
It's quite long. I do like the rumbling drums that kick off the track. I think it's a sexy track too.
Okay.
I like the rhythm of it. It's very sexy. It is over long though.
5.5 minutes is long. It is.
Yeah.
Only. A lighter tone but lacking the energy that I'd hoped for. The highlight of this track is the vocal style that is chaotic and direct. The tone of the track overall just doesn't do much for me.
That's the one they released with a video.
Okay.
Have you seen the video?
Nope.
That's quite a good video, actually. So I heard this one a lot. I still really enjoy this one. I feel like it just sucks me in. It takes me long for the ride. All the effects and... Yeah, I'm singing it now, so...
Is that nostalgia because you heard it when you were younger?
No, definitely not.
Okay.
I still enjoy listening to Only.
Getting smaller. Now here's some energy. The faster pacing of the guitars and the Spitfire vocal style is very welcome for me. It's almost a bit punky, and there's some definite Queens of the Stone Age stuff I find in this one. A fun track that I enjoyed.
I love the sound of it. I do like the echo.
Yeah.
But it kind of at the end, the way like the words bounce from ear to ear at the end. It's great energy and bounce to it. Really rich guitars that all build nicely.
Mm.
Really enjoyed that. And I put flip, flop, flip. I really like that flip flop. Yeah. I have to write it down. There's a bit at the beginning.
Right.
Flip, flop.
Yeah, but you doing it is really, really is just no, please don't.
I'm not saying it.
Sunspots. This one I can't say I love or hate really. I'm on the middle of this one. The slow methodical beat style returns. It's got a level of chill that I enjoy, but you can sense that something is being held back. When that is unleashed, it makes the track sound a little bit more unique. I find that this one has more atmosphere than most in the album.
I thought it was a dark, sultry track,
mm-hmm.
and the drum beats punctuating things is great. I really like the last portion where it all kind of just like, it's all laid together.
The line begins to blur. A return to the dirty industrial fuzz. This one is grubby, but in that purposeful Nine Inch Nails way. Feels raw, feels jam style, and then shifts to something cleaner and clearer and more traditional. It works nicely for me, the contrasting battle.
See, I didn't like this one as much as other tracks. It's a nice sound. I enjoyed it, but it didn't grab me the way other songs on the album did.
Okay, but I'm allowed to like it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know. Penultimate track, Beside You in Time. Atmosphere heavy. I will say that I'm not bored at this stage, even though this is a long album. Sadly, this one fails to spark anything aside from some cursory interest in its cinematic value.
Yeah, I do like the effects and layers on it, but it's quite a long track.
It is. It's a long album.
So I think by this point, I think you'd want to just like... tighten up just a bit.
Just don't have this one, I think.
Yeah, I feel I can get rid of this one.
Yeah, I feel like this one could have ended up on the cutting room floor. Yeah. But we do end with Right Where It Belongs. And I love the piano melody and distant drone at the start. The arrival of vocals enhances things, and this ends up being one of my favourite on the album thanks to its prettiness. The volume increase in the latter part just makes it all the more better.
Really nice symphony and piano intro. I like the track and the piano builds when there's the audience cheering when it comes in. I really like that. Really good. I think I listened to a different version to you.
Why?
So I listened to one called Home.
Home? What do you mean?
There's a track after called Home.
Right.
No?
No.
Okay. But just as a note to that Right Where It Belongs, there's a Right Where It Belongs version 2, which is stripped down even further.
Oh, I think I saw this and I knew it was an extended edition, so we don't do extended editions. We always just do the original albums as released.
It was only
released.
Two songs, so it didn't feel like it super extended, because normally it's like loads of stuff. That's why I didn't... Yeah, I should have checked.
Okay,
but
no matter.
Just as a point to Right Where It Belongs, if you like that one, version 2 is stripped down even further, so it's just a piano and Trent. It's really beautiful.
Okay.
Even better than the original one, I would say.
In your opinion, yeah, absolutely. No, I didn't obviously check them out on that front. Listen, so like, I'm going to be straight up about this. I think this album is one of the more forgettable Nine Inch Nails listens. That on there, I don't think it was anything that really, really made me go, oh my God, that is brilliant. I think there was lots of good tracks. Mm. There were a couple of great tracks. Mm. Where I'm like, oh yeah, that was, I enjoyed that for this reason, that reason, that reason. But like, when I think of like the Nine Inch Nails tracks I love, I'd struggle to pick some out from this album.
Okay.
And one of the things I think really goes against it is that a lot of this just sounds like stuff that's come before on other albums.
Right.
That to me, this is probably, for a band that I kind of associate with constantly developing and moving forward, this does not feel like it moves forward at all.
Yeah.
It feels very much like a continuation of what we've been hearing before. Mm. You know?
I'm trying to think what was next after this one.
No, I don't know the discography well enough to be able to picture that. But I certainly don't feel like... I don't feel like it's a unique listen. Whereas I always feel like with Nine Inch Nails, you're always guaranteed something quite unique or something quite interesting or challenging. This didn't really do that for me.
There's some elements that I really liked. So.
I will say it again. Yeah. There are tracks that I think are great. There are three in particular.
Yeah. Go on.
And mine are You Know What You Are, Every Day Is Exactly the Same, and Right Where You Belongs. Right Where It Belongs.
Well, I've got Every Day Is Exactly the Same only, and Right Where It Belongs, but version 2.
Oh, right. So you prefer version 2, right?
They're really even less going on. It's beautiful.
But I know like Nine Inch Nails were super hot at this period of time, so I do think like the fact that it was very successful speaks volumes for it more than anything else.
I think I saw him on this tour, the With Teeth tour at Brixton, and
It should be noted, you've always been a bigger fan of this band than I am.
Yeah.
Always been a bigger fan than I am. I don't love or hate Nine Inch Nails. I like Nine Inch Nails. I like Trent Reznor. I like a lot of... the modern stuff. I also dislike a lot of the modern stuff. I like a lot of the early stuff. I also dislike a lot of the early stuff.
Yeah,
so like it's very much in the middle for me with this band.
So I've seen them 4 times, and unfortunately, I'm not going to go see them at Brixton this year. I think the ticket prices.
Yeah.
I think it's
absolutely
got to be said. Like, I don't think obviously touring has been massively hit, but
so are the general public.
Yeah,
are the people buying your tickets.
Yeah,
do you see what I mean?
It's Brixton Academy with £75 a ticket.
Which is absolutely
bang
out of order. Yeah. It's bang. No, let's be straight up about it. It's bang out of order. Mm. And if you want to pay that, it's more power to you. But we look at that and go, there are bands out there applying a trade, fantastic bands who want a tenner. You go see those bands. You can buy 7 different bands tickets. You spend 75 quid at Brixton, which is not particularly, like I said, for that money, you're like, that's O2 prices.
Yeah.
That's the high end of the O2 Arena prices. Yeah. Come on, man.
Yeah, and I feel like I've seen them in quite good positions.
I've seen Nine Inch Nails. That was enough for me. I've seen them once. That was like, I don't know, 2016, I think, 2017. But I've seen them. That's more than fine by me.
Yeah.
But yeah, With Teeth, what do you reckon? Let us know in the comments. Thank you very much for watching. You can check us out on gbhbell.com as well as on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and Tumblr. Go to Patreon to help us out over there. That's patreon.com/GBHBL, as well as Big Cartel, where you can find some of our merchandise. We have a podcast running on SoundCloud and Apple Podcasts. And of course, if you like this video, do us a favor, hit the subscribe button and help the channel grow. Games, horror, and heavy metal. What else is life for?